Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to my second episode of my podcast. My name is Tabio Mafura, and today I've got a special guest, a teammate of mine. His name is Junior Pokomela. Junior, welcome to my podcast, bro.
Thanks, Tabs, man. Thanks for inviting me.
It's a pleasure, brother. It's a pleasure having you here. We're going to get right into it. We're going to be talking about everything rugby and life off of the field. And tell us more about yourself. How did you get to the Cheetahs? Where did your rugby career start? And yeah.
So I started playing rugby at the age of 7 in grade 1. And obviously I progressed. And then in grade 11, I moved to grade high school. That's when things started shaping up for me. After that, I got a contract to play rugby at the Epic Kings as a junior player. Things went well that side. I played for the EP under 19, won the under 19 Curry Cup. Following year, played S under 20 and got approached by the Cheetahs. And I came here and I've been here for 4 years now.
Oh, that's a long time. And in your journey coming to the Cheetahs, I just want to ask you, what is it that you think a player has to do to become a pro? And then once you are a pro, what is it that you have to do to stay a pro? Because, I mean, we've seen a lot of players that have tried to be professional, but they didn't end up making it. Or guys that did end up being pros, but they didn't last and their career has ended. So what is it that you think that you have to do?
I think people always say you need to work hard. I think that's mandatory. Everyone has to do that.
Yeah.
You go to any union, you see guys working hard on a daily basis. But for me, what really got me here was through certain people in mentorship, certain guys like helping me through. Just because I'm working hard doesn't mean that it'll get me, you know, to become a professional player or make it in rugby.
Yeah.
You need to follow footsteps of certain people. And I was fortunate enough, I was guided by Zondi Stick, the current Springbok coach.
Yeah.
And he used to give me a lot of advice on how to make it. You know, it's easy to drift off in the rugby game.
Sure.
And obviously another thing is easy to make it, but it's tough to stay as a professional rugby player.
Yeah.
So for the guys that are coming through, just work hard, you know, try and get someone to mentor you, try and get someone to speak to you when things aren't going right and when things are really going right as well.
Yeah.
Seek for that advice and try and better yourself every day.
Yeah, that's some good wise words. Thank you, brother. Just want to talk about the injuries that you had and the motivation to get back. I know it's not easy when you get injured and then, you know, you have to start finding your way back because of how hard it is with the rehab. And, you know, some injuries are not easy. And maybe you can tell us more about how you've handled yours and what your motivation is whenever you find yourself in that road.
That's the difficult part about rugby. I've suffered a couple of injuries, two operations on my knee,
yeah,
and one tricky back injury. Mm-hmm. So the knees weren't bad operations with meniscus. So it's normally like you're out for 6 weeks and you can play again. But I had quite a weird back injury. It was like more of a nerve injury where it's like the nerves aren't running through the canal. So I get like pins and needles in my legs.
Yeah.
And when I went to the doctor, I didn't realize that it was like quite a big thing. Went to the doctor. The doctors were shocked. I had to rush for MRI. Went from MRI, saw a specialist. Specialist was like, dude, you need to stay off your feet for 6 weeks.
Yeah.
After that, we need
to evaluate. Is that after you come back or?
No. I was still playing. And then
yeah,
I used to get those pins and needles. And then the next minute, I told the doc the one time, I was like, dude, I'm feeling this weird pain. Obviously my hamstrings. And it was like, dude, let me just send you for MRI. MRI came back. Said one of the discs is bulging, et cetera, et cetera. Because I didn't understand.
What is that? Did you understand what that is?
I didn't understand. Yeah. So it's where the nerves go through. And
is this in your back now?
In my back, yeah. And then especially like, no, 6 weeks, you're out, don't do anything, don't cycle, nothing. So I was like, okay, boom, okay, what's happening now?
Yeah.
After 6 weeks, I saw him. He was like, okay, cool, now you can start cycling. You can't run, you can't do anything, you can't even gym. And then it was just like that, you know, with the nerves, you can't really tell how long they take to recover. You just need to work every day and see how to progress every day.
Mm-hmm.
Then I came back and I played season. I didn't finish the season because I had the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
And then I had to go to the doctor again. Luckily, the canal was still the same, like the spacing didn't decrease or whatsoever. It was still the same space.
That's
good. And I had to be out for another 6 weeks.
Oh.
And then, you know, it hits you mentally. Now you start you know, not knowing what to do. Sure. Got a little bit fat, if I can put it that way. I got a little bit fat because I was a little bit depressed.
Did you get into trouble with the
coaches? No.
Yeah.
So it was more of a mental game, and started seeking advice, man. Started seeing a professional psychologist, you know, yeah. not just for my injury, for other aspects as well. And it was tough mentally, man, but I worked on my mental part, and then my physical part, and that's where I think I got to succeed, you know?
Yeah, that's good to hear. And you said you've been with the Cheetahs for 4 years now. That's a very long time. I think that's some loyalty to the Cheetahs. Let's talk a little bit about that. What is it that has made you stay with the Cheetahs so long? I mean, how many caps do you have?
I think over 50 now.
Over 50, I mean, that's amazing. Not everyone can do that, honestly. I mean, I admire that about you. And
thanks, bro.
I just want to talk a little bit more about the Cheetahs and what made you stay with them for so long. Because, I mean, we've seen a lot of guys come and go. And for you, you've been with them for a long time. And I think that's a very great thing.
No, it is great, man. But the one thing I can say is opportunity, man. You know, yeah. I get to play here. I haven't really had any bumps whatsoever. Every coach that came in has really given me the chance to showcase my talent.
Yeah.
And that's why I've been loyal to the Cheetahs, you know, as long as I get to do what I love.
Yeah.
You understand? Guys have obviously, as you said, guys have came, guys have gone. Mm-hmm. So, but me, I've been here and I've been playing. So that's why I'm loyal to the Cheetahs, because they give me the opportunity to do what I love, you know?
Yeah.
So yeah, bro.
Now, as you know, the coronavirus impacted everyone, and with us, we had to stop playing, and we were having a great season. I just want to get your thoughts on what you think about the season starting now. I mean, we're back in training now, and we might start playing at the end of this month or next month, and we might not have any fans. What do you think about us moving forward and playing and not having any fans? Is that going to impact your game?
Bro, that's going to be tough. That's really going to be tough. Obviously, with the coronavirus, everyone's affected, not just the rugby players. Sure. Everyone all over the world, people are dying every single day.
Yeah.
So, but obviously, as you said, we might start playing soon. I don't know if it's in August or it's going to be in September.
Week,
hopefully, it's going to be in August.
Yeah.
It's going to be different, man. I've been watching soccer, you know, the Premier League, and the stadiums are empty, man.
It's not the same, man.
Something that you got to get used to, you know. Yeah. So, as long as we can get to do what we love, Tabs,
yeah,
you know, that'll be nice. We're worried about the fans. We'll worry about the fans later on. Obviously, now it's still a bit of a tricky situation.
True.
But we got to do what we got to do, man, you know.
Yeah, and I just want to know, is there a moment or a time where you ever thought that your rugby career was over because of the coronavirus maybe, or an injury? Was there ever a time you thought you were done with rugby?
No, man, I've never had that moment, to be quite honest. And I'm grateful that I didn't get to that stage.
Yeah.
So with coronavirus, I knew eventually it'll pass. I don't know when, but we're confident that obviously people that are behind it will find, you know, the certain things to kind of kill it off. So it's just a waiting game. Now I just need to be patient and comply with the government regulations, man.
That's positive, eh? I mean, that just says, like, that just tells me that you back yourself, bro. I won't lie. Because, I mean, I've had to think to myself, listen, if rugby is done now, what am I going to do? And with that being said, my next question is to ask you, if you weren't playing rugby, what would you be doing? Do you know what you would be doing?
No, I don't.
You don't?
No, I don't. Now I'm on the path of trying to figure out what I want to do after rugby.
That's good.
As much as I'm young, the game can end any time, you know, it can end tomorrow or today. So I'm currently studying, you know, I'm finishing up my degree next year.
That's awesome.
But obviously I'm ready to work in the office from 9 to 5. So I'm trying to seek other venues.
Yeah.
And see what else can I do when I'm done playing the game.
Yeah.
So hopefully in a year or two, I'll be able to know what I'll be doing after the game. You know?
That's good to hear, man.
Yeah.
Do you have any goals for the future? I mean, once the rugby has started and we start getting into things again?
My goal is just to get into pitch, man, and play for the Cheetahs again. Anything else, whatever comes next, you know, will come. But my main goal is to play and just to get the team going again, man.
That's awesome. And last but not least, some advice for the young and upcoming rugby players. I mean, what would you tell a younger version of yourself with the knowledge that you have now and stuff that you know now? What would you tell a younger version of yourself?
I think I'd just say work hard, you know, enjoy your rugby, enjoy your high school, wherever you are in high school or university, enjoy your rugby. Because that's the most important thing, because when you get to the professional setup. It's not just about enjoyment anymore.
Yeah.
It's tactical side of things, you know. It's, the pressure increases as well. So I would say while you're still young, enjoy your rugby, you know, have fun. And seek mentorship, man. Seek mentorship. And I guess when you have someone that you look up to that can help you, you know, guide you through your path, that helps. That helps a lot.
That's true. Now, once again, wise words from Junior Pokomela. And that is it from the second episode. I just want to thank you for being here and just sharing your wise words. And hopefully we can have you once again if we do this again. And just thanking Career Magazine for hosting this and making it a dream come true.
Thanks, my boy. Appreciate it, man.
Pleasure, brother.
Easy.